Hello, everyone. We have a fantastic program coming up. It combines the work of a Richmond native, Zachary Wadsworth, who's going to be home to hear his composition played by the Richmond Symphony, a fantastic violin concerto by Korngold with the artist Philippe Quint, and one of the great symphonies of the repertoire that is not played all that often, unfortunately. This is the Symphony No. 4, subtitled The Inextinguishable, by the Danish composer Carl Nielsen. We're actually celebrating Nielsen's 150th birthday this year, and so I think it's appropriate to play this landmark piece of the repertoire. It comes from a time just before and entering World War I, a very turbulent period of European history from 1914 to 1916 as Nielsen was writing this work. He chose the subtitle Inextinguishable and appended it to the piece. By it, he meant something about the elemental will to live, that life and music are together in one basic thought, a kind of life force. And this piece is very life-affirming in its own way. A lot of times we talk about music being a universal language and how music expresses a variety of emotions that cannot be conveyed by words. So I think this is Nielsen's attempt to underline this kind of elemental quality of music and connecting it to this one very specific word. The piece opens with a kind of almost terrifying music. It's very active, it's very loud, it's very dramatic, and I think gives us a good idea about the turbulent atmosphere in which Nielsen and the rest of his fellow Europe was living at that time. This symphony is played without pause, and as we go through the four movements, we find ourselves in very different kinds of sonic worlds, from that very powerful, dramatic opening to a second movement, which is very gracious, very elegant, very quiet. And then ultimately, as we lead to the final movement, the music builds and builds into this section, which Nielsen himself writes in the score, glorioso. It's not really a tempo marking, but it's meant to convey this sense of majestic glory that ends the piece. Along the way, there's also a very dramatic and loud and seemingly angry, almost a battle between the two timpanists. In fact, Nielsen actually says in the score that whether they're playing loudly or softly, they have to play in a very menacing kind of manner. So it gives an undercurrent to this sense of turbulence. But I thought it would be interesting to explore some of Nielsen's own words about why he chose this title, The Inextinguishable, and what it means, how he connects this sense of music and life. In fact, he says, "Music is life. As soon as even a single note sounds in the air or through space, it is the result of life. It is an immediate expression of the will to life." The symphony evokes the most primal sources of life and the wellspring of the life feeling, that is, what lies behind all human, animal, and plant life as we perceive it or live it. He talks about his method of writing as an ordering of musical material. He speaks about it in the the context of being almost like water. He describes the ordering of the musical material is the fruit of deliberation by the composer. In the same way as when an engineer sets up dikes and sluices for the water during a flood. That sense of channeling emotion, of channeling sound, I think is very important. He goes further. It is an expression of what makes the birds cry, the animals roar, bleat, run, and fight, and humans moan, groan, exult, and shout without any explanation. He's talking about the most fundamental aspects of life, whether it's ourselves or our world around us. And finally, he tells us, for it is life, whereas the other arts only represent and paraphrase life. Life is indomitable and inextinguishable. Music is life, and like it, inextinguishable.